In this video, I will show you how to make buttonholes by hand. I prepare here a piece of fabric. Usually we make buttonholes on double layer of fabric, not on one. And I know there are other tutorials how to make buttonholes by hand, but I am doing it a little bit differently, and I think my way is a little bit simpler and faster. So first of all, I'm using fusible web, double-sided fusible interfacing, so I can glue two layers of fabric together so they don't shift. We need to use interfacing anyway when we are making buttonholes, so why not to use fusible web, and two layers of fabric will be connected permanently. Well, if you don't have this big piece of interfacing, you can use these rolls, which usually we are usually using them for hems. Fusible web. For this project, I can use pearl cotton thread, which is thicker than regular thread, or embroidery thread number 10. For bobbin works, usually we use this embroidery thread. These threads are thicker, and it is better for making buttonholes by hand. I have to condition the thread so it doesn't tangle. For this, we can use Burt's Bees lip balm and just put a thread like that and cut. I take the needle with bigger eye because the thread is thicker. You can use needle threader, of course. So this is ready. Now I take my button and mark the length of the buttonhole. The length of the buttonhole has to be a little bit bigger than the diameter of the button, like 1/8 of an inch or a few millimeters from each side. Here and I'm using just a regular fabric marker. Okay, I marked my buttonhole. Now I have to mark around lines in which my needle will go, so I can keep equal distance from the cut on each side. Where is 1/8 of an inch here? Here it is. Okay, this is my buttonhole. I marked it. Now I can cut. I'm going to use this cutting tool. Now we have to cut all these small threads that are coming, And the buttonhole will be ready for sewing. As you can see, quite a lot of threads are coming. We have to cut them all. Okay, now we will start from here. Oh, I didn't make a knot. So let's make a knot. Kind of too big. Okay, let's start from here. So the first stitch, I'm doing like this. Loop. I am going in the loop from down, not from here, but from down twice. One, two. So I can make a knot on top here, right at the edge of the cut. Okay, now I can continue. It's not really easy to keep equal distance between stitches. This is buttonhole stitch. Okay, so see the loop. Now you have to put the needle from down up. So it will make a knot. It will make a knot right at the edge. Again, loop. See the loop. And we go from down up, making a knot. Okay, again, loop. We go from down up, and here is the knot at the edge of the buttonhole. This stitch called buttonhole stitch. It's about the same like blanket stitch, but you have to insert the needle in the loop from down, not from up. So you will make the knot on at the edge of the buttonhole. As you can see, I wasn't able to keep equal distance between stitches. It's not really easy, especially with my camera in front of me. But you can keep it close to your eyes, closer to your eyes. Okay, this is the loop, and we go from down up. That's how buttonhole stitch is made. And it's really very fast to do. You go just from down up. Okay, here is the end of the buttonhole. We make few stitches like that. now bring the needle on the right side through the cut, turn buttonhole around, and let's continue on this side. Okay, see the loop? You go from down up and you have nice knot here. Go from down up trying to keep the distance equal between my stitches. Not always successful, but still it's not too bad. Now I have to make few stitches here at the end of the buttonhole. Okay, now I'm bringing the needle through the opening and we'll continue. Okay, from down up. Okay, this is the finished buttonhole. Of course, if you are using the thread that's matching your fabric, the buttonhole will look much better. If I'm using contrast threads to just to show you how it is done, I may have not so good buttonhole. Okay, now we go on the wrong side and make a knot to finish this stitch. So this is the buttonhole. You can check how it fits. If you liked this sewing tutorial, you may be interested in reading my blog post about hand-sewn buttonholes. There you can find info on why we need to make buttonholes by hand, even if everybody now has a buttonhole foot for a sewing machine. Check out the link under this video. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you like to learn sewing for more tips, tutorials, and inspiration.